with Precision Zone, and I'm going to be showing how you to get rid of an A00 or an A81 alarm on a Yaskawa Sigma I that the motor has a 12-bit absolute encoder. The very first part of the procedure is to turn on the drive and let it sit for 3 minutes. Now we've go ahead and started, and you can see we have A81 on our digital operator right here, and this is the alarm that we are going to be trying to clear. And like I was saying, the first step is turn the drive on and leave it set for 3 minutes. After that, we're going to power off the machine and short a couple of pins. On the 17 pin connector, it's going to be R and S, and on the 15 and 12 pin connectors, they're going to be a couple different as well, and I'll show those. One way to know if your motor has a 12-bit absolute encoder installed on it is by the nameplate. It'll read SGMG for Sigma 1, there'll be a dash, a kilowatt size, then there'll be a letter that denotes what voltage it runs at, and then the fourth letter will be a W. If the fourth letter is a W, that means it has a 12-bit absolute encoder. Now, if that fourth letter is an S, that is a 15-bit absolute encoder, and this procedure won't work. Also, unfortunately, this procedure hardly ever works on the first time. We'll see how lucky I get. So, me saying that, if it doesn't work on the first time, just keep trying it and keep trying it and keep trying it. But if it keeps happening after like 4 or 5 different times, please contact us here at Precision Zone and we'll try to figure out what is going on. So after the motor has been powered on for 3 minutes, you're going to go ahead and disconnect it from power and short a couple of the pins. So let's go ahead and take a quick look at the 12 and 15 pin connectors, which ones we're going to short. Okay, so on this 15 pin connector, we're going to be shorting pins 13 and 14 together. So pins 13 and pins 14. And now the manual says to do it for at least 3 seconds. Me personally, when I like to do this, I do it for about 30, and that seems to work really well for me. Also, on this 12 pin connector, you're going to be shorting out pins 9 and 12. Again, like I said, manual says for 3 seconds. I like to do it for 30. That's always worked best for me. So I think between camera magic and our actual 3 minutes, I think our time is up. So let's go ahead and power off the drive. You want to go ahead and remove the feedback cable. And on this 17 pin connector, what we're going to be shorting is R and S. And that is these two pins right here, pins R and S. If you see the keyway in the middle, there's a star pattern, and the bottom two are R and S. And you can either use these alligator clips or a little piece of short wire. And like I was saying, manual says 3 seconds. I like to do more like 30 seconds. Well, that should be long enough. Let's go ahead and remove the jumper and connect everything back up. Now that's all connected, let's go ahead and power back on the drive. Hey, and look at that, with any luck, we cleared that alarm. Like I was saying, it looks like I just got lucky being able to do this on the first time. But please, if it doesn't work on the first time, try it 2-3 times, you'll eventually get it. But let's go ahead and make sure that this alarm is cleared. Let's go ahead and jog the motor real quick. Well, it looks like we've successfully cleared that alarm and hopefully it's gone for good. But if you've tried this over and over again and you still cannot get the alarm to clear, there is another procedure, but unfortunately, you will have to perform some type of modification to the encoder cable. Now, somewhere along the lines, Yaskawa's 12-bit absolute encoder became a revision. And after that revision date, you no longer can reset the encoder by just simply taking off the encoder connector and shorting those two wires. After the change was made, you have to be able to short those two wires with the power on the encoder. Now, unfortunately, you will have to do some type of modification in order for this to happen. Now, if you can send your encoder cable into us and we'll be able to perform that modification for you, or if you would like, we can supply you with the parts and you can do that modification yourself. A couple of the different reasons why you might even be getting these alarms are because of a bad battery, the capacitors in the encoder are going bad, or if you've simply just removed or replaced your motor, the first time that you do reinstall it, you're gonna have this 81 alarm and you're gonna have to reset it. So, if you have any questions about how to do this or if you need any more help, you can always find us at precisionzone.com. Please reach out to us. We'll be more than happy to help you get your machine up and running. Thanks for watching.